जनरल अनिल चैत, GOC&C सेंट्रल कमांड, जनरल चंदेले, मैनेजिंग एडिटर जियो इंटेलिजेंस एंड एडवाइजर, श्री कौशिक चक्रवर्ती, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट हेक्सागन इंडिया, डॉक्टर MP नारायणन, चेयरमैन जियो स्पेशल मीडिया एंड कम्युनिकेशंस, श्री संजय कुमार, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड गेस्ट्स, पार्टिसिपेंट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एट द आउटसेट आई विश टू थैंक जियो इंटेलिजेंस इंडिया फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्पीक टू दिस डिस्टिंग्विश्ड ऑडियंस. आई एम डिलाइटेड टू बी हियर दिस मॉर्निंग एंड टू इनॉग्रेट दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन अ सब्जेक्ट ऑफ कंटेम्पररी इंटरेस्ट, जियो स्पेशल फोर्स मल्टीप्लायर फॉर मॉडर्न वॉरफेयर. From ancient maps to present-day satellite-based systems, geospatial technology has come a long way and impacts us in myriad ways. Personal navigation systems, location-based services, weather forecasting, telecommunications, agriculture, infrastructure planning, remote sensing, maritime domain awareness, precision targeting, the uses of geospatial technology are infinite. Quite obviously, space and information technologies have contributed the most in growth of the geospatial industry. Our government agencies dealing with geospatial information have evolved over time. The Survey of India is the oldest scientific department of the Government of India. Similarly, the National Hydrographic Office, with over 300 years of survey experience in Indian waters, remains at the forefront of cartographic technology, producing charts that are amongst the best in the world. In fact, the Indian Navy is regularly called upon to provide hydrographic survey assistance to our friendly maritime neighbors in the Indian Ocean region. In space too, our significant achievements in the field of remote sensing, communications and ongoing projects such as Indian Regional Navigational Satellite System augur well for the indigenous geospatial industry. Our capabilities in information and communication technologies are well established and recognized. All these therefore position India favorably to harness geospatial technology for overall national development and security. To synergize our geospatial resources and capabilities for civil applications, the National Spatial Data Infrastructure was initiated in June 2006. Today's conference focuses on the military dimension of this powerful technology, where too this is all pervasive. The knowledge of terrain forms the essence of military operations. Geospatial tools for navigation, situational awareness, command and control, operations, as also training and maintenance, forms the core of any military's functioning. Space-based navigation is one of the major achievements of this technology, with the GPS and GLONASS systems having existed for nearly two decades now. However, concerns of data ownership, besides the need for autonomy and redundancy, have driven the development of alternatives such as the EU's Galileo, China's Beidou, and our own IRNSS, which is expected to fructify within the next few years. Having an indigenous satellite navigation system will boost military capabilities across the spectrum, from basic navigation to high-precision ordnance delivery. The armed forces are committed to self-reliance and would support all efforts of the industry in that direction. ISR is another area that has been revolutionized by geospatial technology towards improving situational awareness. Space-based surveillance and live data streamed from UAVs can drastically shorten sensor to shooter loop. Fusion of information from multiple sensors provides unprecedented battle space transparency, enabling cooperative engagement over extended ranges. Jointless is the mantra for modern warfare. Therefore, common geospatial reference has enabled integration of situational data from different services for achieving operational synergy. Maritime security is also intricately linked with geospatial intelligence. Seas, due to their vastness and ungoverned nature, are susceptible to a variety of transnational crimes. The 26/11 Mumbai attack is a grim reminder of the vulnerability of the maritime domain and porosity of our long coastline. We have already initiated a slew of measures such as coastal radar chains and AIS networks to improve our maritime domain awareness off and along our coast. Efforts are on to set up the NQI network and to establish a national MDA system to seamlessly integrate information from multiple sources and maritime agencies. We also have been supporting several friendly IOR littorals with similar infrastructure to enhance their MDA. Needless to say, geospatial applications are the core of most of these projects. Along with numerous opportunities, geospatial technology, however, also brings in its share of challenges. One of the foremost challenges that military geospatial applications face is the timely availability, integrity, and security of information. The challenge, therefore, is to integrate this vast amount of data and create applications so that it can be optimally utilized. Even benign military tasks such as disaster response would need accurate and timely geospatial intelligence. The NSDI, which I alluded to earlier, has been created for such non-military applications. Apart from government agencies, the industry, including private entities, are fast evolving into major contributors of real-time geospatial intelligence. Their data obviously resides on the cloud or the web and is primarily targeted at mobile and internet users. So how do we harness this information for military applications? There are a few challenges here too. The next hurdle is compatibility. Military networks, combat management systems, weapons, sensors, etc. are normally insulated from the internet and run on customized software. So the moot question is, should the military deprive itself of real-time open-source geospatial intelligence, or should we be looking at technological solutions to bring in compatibility? If we do decide to plug into the cloud, how does military hardware and software, which have long exploitation cycles, keep pace with the rapid progress in the geospatial field? Answers to these questions can open up new opportunities for the industry, as also the end users in the military. Then there are challenges in data processing and mining. While satellites and information technology allows us to gather large volumes of data, how do we convert them into actionable intelligence available when required? This again calls for innovative solutions. The importance of data security, reliability, and integrity needs re-emphasis. Many would recall in August last year how doctored messages over mobile and social networks triggered a nationwide exodus of our people from the Northeast residing in other states. Even data from reliable sources can be tampered on the net. I am glad that the conference will be focusing on such emergent issues. I also note that the plenary sessions have been devoted to cyber warfare, space weaponization, and special forces, which are subjects of current relevance to the armed forces. I am therefore hopeful that the deliberations will yield valuable inputs for the services. To conclude, I wish to reiterate that the geospatial field holds tremendous potential for future warfare, provided we can maximize the opportunities and overcome the challenges. I therefore wish you success in your deliberations and once again thank the organizers for having given me this opportunity. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for your attention. Jai Hind.